In today's video, I'll tell you all about our recent Mexican Riviera cruise on Carnival Panorama. It was a really nice 7-day cruise out of Southern California, visiting the Mexican ports of Puerto Vallarta, Mazatlan, and Cabo San Lucas. I'm going to show you what we did each day of the cruise, including not just one, but two of the best shore excursions we've ever been on. And hopefully by the end of the video, you'll see why I think Carnival Panorama is one of the best cruise ships in the world. If you're new to my channel, let me introduce myself. I'm Jim Zim, a true cruise fanatic, having done 55 cruises on 7 different cruise lines since 1996. And I'm back at home now after 7 days aboard Carnival Panorama. That means I've now sailed over 200 days with Carnival, putting me in the highest level of their loyalty program. And in case you don't know, I am a licensed commercial drone pilot, so when you see a nice aerial shot like this of Carnival Panorama in today's video, that's not some stock footage that I got from Carnival. Everything you're going to see today is my original video that I personally shot. My story begins today in Los Angeles, where we took an Uber down to the cruise port in Long Beach. Carnival Panorama sails out of the Long Beach Cruise Terminal, which is the building under the geodesic dome next to the Queen Mary. And the check-in process was very efficient, so it wasn't long before we were on the gangway boarding the ship. It probably helped that the ship was only going to be at about 2/3 capacity for this sailing. Our first order of business was to drop off our carry-ons at our cabin. But right after that, we headed up to Guy's Burger Joint for lunch. Now, if you've never had a Guy Fieri burger before, this is not only by far the best burger you'll ever have on a cruise ship, but I'd say that it may just be the best burger I've ever had, period, at sea or on land. It had been 2 years since my last Guy Fieri food, and I had really been looking forward to it. In fact, I joked with my wife that my Guy Fieri burger was so good that it brought me to tears.
I told myself I wouldn't cry.
I was joking, of course, but I really do like Guy Fieri food, and over the next 7 days, I would eat plenty of it. Not just the burgers, but also the stuff at Guy's Peg and Anchor specialty restaurant, too. After lunch, we headed down to the Havana pool area at the back of the ship for cocktails. The Havana area, with 2 hot tubs, a swimming pool, a sun deck, and a bar, is a quiet, uncrowded area of the ship that most passengers don't have access to. The only people who are allowed to enter the Havana area are people who have booked a cabin back here in the Havana section of the ship. These cabins cost a little more, but it's totally worth it to have access to this little oasis on the ship. I'm 64 years old, and I like a quiet, relaxing cruise experience, so hanging out at the main pool area with thousands of other passengers and loud music playing all the time, it's just not for me. But the Havana pool area is quiet and uncrowded and is one of my favorite ways to cruise. Joining us this week on the cruise are our friends Bob and Joan. We met them last year on a Columbia River cruise with American Cruise Lines and really hit it off. We wanted to do another cruise together, so here we all are. Now, I'm sure there was a very energetic party for sail away out at the main pool with loud music and dancing, but back here at the Havana pool, things were much more relaxed. I love it. I really don't think I could ever go back to the old Carnival ships that don't have one of these quiet, uncrowded Havana areas. Sometimes sailing out of Southern California in January or February, the weather can be quite cool, but our timing was great. There was a heat wave this week. I was in shorts and a short-sleeved shirt pretty much all day until the sun finally set. Now, it had been 2 years since the last time I was on Carnival Panorama, and for 2 years, I had been craving Guy Fieri food, so when dinner time rolled around, Kellen and I headed to the Pig and Anchor restaurant, and I ordered the trash can nachos. Probably at this point, after a Guy burger for lunch and trash can nachos for dinner, you're starting to realize that my tastes in food run pretty casual. Should I be embarrassed to admit that at no point during the cruise did I eat dinner in the main dining room? After dinner, we went to the comedy club and had some good laughs, and then checked out the band that was playing in Ocean Plaza. The next morning, Sunday, we had breakfast in the buffet restaurant, which is known as the Lido Marketplace. In fact, we had breakfast there every morning of the cruise. After breakfast, it was wonderfully warm outside, and we spent most of the morning in the Havana area. The water temperature in the swimming pool was 83 degrees, and the hot tubs were at 101 degrees. I actually bring a pool thermometer with me when I'm making these travel videos, because it's one thing for me to say that the pool was cold or the pool was warm, and it's so much better to be able to actually quantify it with a firm number so that you know you're not just hearing my opinion. For lunch today, we got to attend a special party that was thrown for passengers in the top tier of Carnival's loyalty program. Experienced cruisers know the good ships from the not-so-good ones, so that's why there were a lot of diamond-level guests sailing on Carnival Panorama this week. Kellen started her lunch with a nice salad, and I had lobster bisque. And for her entree, Kellen had some kind of seafood, I think it was halibut, and I had a steak. After lunch, I took a walk around the ship just to get some shots of everyone enjoying the great weather on this sea day. This was the scene out at the main pool area. Notice that in the pool itself, it's primarily kids with their parents or grandparents. At the aft pool on deck 10, the atmosphere is more relaxed and not as loud. This is the pool that adults tend to use, but you do still have kids too. If you want to avoid kids completely, you need to be in the Havana area. No one under 13 years of age is allowed back here. This happened to be Super Bowl Sunday, and a cruise ship is a very fun place to watch the Super Bowl with a big crowd and lots of cheering for both teams. The LA Rams were in the Super Bowl this year, and our cruise was out of the LA area, so there were definitely more Rams fans on board than Bengals fans. We watched the game from several different venues, first in the sports bar, which was quite crowded, as you might imagine, then the Limelight Lounge, but we were a little uncomfortable there because a lot of people there weren't wearing masks. And then we finally ended up finding some seats out at the main pool area. That ended up being our favorite place to watch the game because there was such a big crowd there, and cheering along with a big crowd while watching the big game turned out to be a lot of fun. That evening, after a nice sunset, we headed to the main theater to enjoy a big production show, and we also stopped by the Havana Bar to listen to some live music. The next day, Monday, was our second sea day. The weather was fantastic again, and even warmer than the day before. We spent most of the day in the Havana area because it's so comfortable, relaxed, and uncrowded there. We had a lot of fun chatting and drinking with our friends Bob and Joan. And being a sea day, and everybody just totally in a vacation mood, everyone back in the Havana area was having a good time and enjoying themselves. It was Valentine's Day, too, and the next time we stopped back at our cabin, our steward had posted a little greeting on our mirror. For lunch, I decided to visit the Pig and Anchor to enjoy some great Guy Fieri barbecue food. On sea days, they offer a buffet lunch at the Pig and Anchor at no additional charge, and my trick is to grab a selection of various meats from the Pig and Anchor buffet line, and then to take that over to Guy's burger joint and get an order of fries to make it a perfect casual barbecue lunch. After lunch, we were back to the Havana pool area for more cocktails and relaxing. my idea of a nice sea day. And even though I had Guy Fieri barbecue buffet for lunch, I still hadn't quite satisfied my craving. So for dinner that night, believe it or not, we visited the Pig and Anchor again, where I had the brisket, something they don't offer on the lunch menu. It's definitely one of the best things on the menu. At night, they have entertainment in the Pig and Anchor, too. On this night, it was a singer/guitarist. We also went to see a show in the Liquid Lounge and visited Ocean Plaza to listen to a few songs from the band that was playing there. On Tuesday morning, our ship arrived in our first port of call, Puerto Vallarta, Mexico. We had a nice breakfast on the ship, and then we headed off on a really great shore excursion. This is our favorite thing to do in Puerto Vallarta on a cruise. It's an excursion called Las Calitas Beach Hideaway. If you're a beach person, you would love this excursion. My wife and I have done this 3 or 4 times on our previous cruises to Puerto Vallarta. We love it that much. There's a boat that takes you from the cruise ship over to Las Calitas Beach. This is a private beach, not a public beach, so it's protected and secluded. When you spend the day there, you are not bothered by locals trying to sell you trinkets all day. Las Calitas Beach is just a little slice of paradise where you can spend the day relaxing at the beach and no one's going to bother you. In fact, quite the opposite. The staff will spoil you. They serve a nice lunch, and the rest of the day while you're relaxing, the wait staff will bring you drinks. This is an all-inclusive deal, so everything's included. Over the winter, back at our home in Washington State, on a snowy day, this was the kind of vacation day we were dreaming of. Relaxing on the beach, drinking cocktails, swimming in the ocean, not a care in the world. If you're a beach person, you've really got to do this excursion in Puerto Vallarta, the Las Calitas Beach Hideaway. Now, if you've got teenagers, this is a good excursion to bring them on, too. You can relax on the beach while they enjoy adventurous activities like several water slides and a zip line that ends in the water. We also like that they have macaws at Las Calitas because my wife and I are really into macaws. Back on board the ship after our day at Las Calitas Beach, we grabbed burgers at Guy's Burger Joint, and then we did next to nothing for the entire evening. I watched a little karaoke at the Havana bar, but that was about it for the day. Hey, I just want to mention that if you're interested in booking a cruise on Carnival or on any other cruise line, or perhaps a vacation at an all-inclusive land resort, feel free to use the services of my travel agent, Caitlin Gallagher. Now, it's not about price. In most cases, a travel agent doesn't get you a better price than you could get by booking it yourself directly with the cruise line. It's about having someone to make things easier for you, someone to do the dirty work. Let Caitlin be the one on hold with the cruise line so you don't have to be. And she's there to keep you from making any rookie mistakes, like booking a cabin in a bad location. So take my advice, contact Caitlin, get her working for you. On Wednesday, Carnival Panorama was in Mazatlan, and we went on a shore excursion known as the All-Inclusive Beach Resort Getaway. Basically, they bus you over to the El Cid Marina Beach Club, and you get to spend several hours there with lunch and drinks included. But this was actually the low point of the cruise for us. In retrospect, we would have had a better time if we had just stayed aboard the ship for the day and enjoyed cocktails out at the Havana pool. Now, we did enjoy the lunch on the excursion. I had fajitas, and my wife had barbecued chicken, and they were very generous about supplying us with drinks the entire time we were on the beach. But the problem was that this just wasn't the kind of beach you want to spend hours at. First off, the surf was kind of rough, so almost no one went in the water. Pretty much all there was to do was to sit in a lounger the whole time. We were lucky to get one in the shade. We got one of the last ones available, and not everyone was so lucky. In the real problem was that this was a public beach, not a private one. So every local vendor with something to sell was there on the beach hounding the tourists to buy something. Here is a picture from the carnival website that they use to sell this excursion. Notice that you only see two people relaxing peacefully, and there's about 30 or 40 empty loungers. See those yellow ropes? I knew when I saw the ropes in the photo that it meant this was a public beach. Those ropes were to designate where the public beach ended and the hotel's private beach begins. Usually that means vendors have to stay on the public part of the beach and can't cross into the hotel's property to bug the relaxing tourists. But this hotel did something I've never seen before. They were actually letting the vendors come in to the roped-off section of beach to try to sell stuff to the tourists. What they did was have the vendors form a line, and then they'd let each one come in and walk all the way up and down through each row of loungers trying to sell us stuff. So for the entire time we were there, trying to relax and have a good time on the beach, we got hounded by a parade of vendors coming up to our lounger and asking us if we wanted to buy what they were selling. It got really annoying over the course of the afternoon. I would never do this excursion again or recommend it to my friends. The only situation where this excursion might make sense for someone is someone who does not have the drink package on the ship that would like to spend several hours at the beach with unlimited drinks and lunch at a fixed price. But you have to put up with a lot, and it just wasn't worth it to me. Back on board the ship, we sailed away at sunset. The port of Mazatlan is an industrial port, so it's not much to look at. After a disappointing day ashore, I was glad to be back on board, enjoying the peace and quiet of the Havana area as we headed back out to sea. When we woke up on Thursday morning, the ship was anchored just off Cabo San Lucas. This was going to end up being a great day for us. After a disappointing shore excursion the day before, today was going to be one of those vacation days that we will probably never forget. We took an excursion on a private yacht with our friends Jamie and Brenda. So it was just the four of us with a crew of three on the yacht to take care of us. They showed us some of the sights at Land's End, and then we headed out to open water for some whale watching. Now, I already did a complete video all about this amazing excursion. I'm putting a link to that video up in the corner of the screen if you'd like to watch that. I don't want to just repeat all that same stuff in this video, so let's just say that we had the best whale watching ever, including watching a mother and her baby. And I would rank it up there among the best vacation experiences we've ever had in all of our travels. So if you haven't already seen it, do yourself a favor, go watch that video about the excursion. After the whale watching, I was able to launch my drone from the yacht and fly it over to where Carnival Panorama was at anchor. By the way, Carnival Miracle was in Cabo that day too. I love flying the drone, and to be able to shoot these great aerial shots of one of my favorite cruise ships, it was just a dream come true for me. And I was even able to get this interesting view of the Havana area of the ship, our favorite place to relax in a quiet, uncrowded little oasis at the back of the ship that most passengers don't have access to. It was about 3:30 p.m. Thursday afternoon when Carnival Panorama had to start heading north in order to get us back to Long Beach by Saturday morning. You can see Carnival Miracle still at anchor as we began sailing back home. We got one last look at Land's End, the rock formation at the tip of Baja California. That evening, we met up with our friends Bob and Joan for the only fancy-smancy dinner we had during the cruise. Usually, Kellen and I prefer our meals to be very casual, but tonight, we wanted the steakhouse experience. Kellen had a filet. I ordered the ribeye. And oh, by the way, check out the cheesecake that they serve for dessert. Friday was our last full day aboard Carnival Panorama. It was a sea day, as we sailed north to get back to Southern California. We spent much of the day just relaxing in the Havana area of the ship. Notice that no one was in the pool, only the hot tub. You almost always have quite a bit cooler weather on the last sea day of a Mexican Riviera cruise. The ship's moving at full speed to get us back in time, and it's usually sailing against the prevailing winds, so the trick on the last sea day is always to find a wind-protected place to hang out. For lunch, I absolutely had to have one last Guy Fieri burger before we got back home. And for dinner that night, all four of us headed to the Pig and Anchor one last time. Bob and Joan had the famous trash can nachos, and Kellen and I shared what they call the whole smoker, which is like a sampler, a little bit of everything from the barbecue smoker. I spent a little bit of time on that last sea day walking around the ship, seeing how everyone else was spending their last day aboard, and shooting a little video of some of the ship's most iconic features. As we woke up on Saturday morning, we were pulling in to the port of Long Beach, Carnival Panorama's home port. It was a typical, beautiful Southern California morning. The crew was busy as usual, keeping everything nice and tidy. And as we made it back to the Long Beach cruise terminal under the geodesic dome next to the Queen Mary, it was time for us to disembark so that a whole new set of guests could come aboard later that afternoon. I've got several other videos about Carnival Panorama that I'm working on. Those will be showing up here on my YouTube channel in the coming weeks. As we wrap this video up, I just want to make sure that I'm crystal clear on one point. I think Carnival Panorama is one of the greatest cruise ships in the world. If you have a chance to book a vacation on Carnival Panorama, you should definitely do so. If you're looking for a relaxing, uncrowded cruise without kids, consider booking a cabin in the Havana area of the ship. That's how I do it. But if you're young or if you have young kids and you're looking for a more fun and exciting cruise experience, you can get that on Carnival Panorama too. The ship truly has something for everyone. I'm Jim Zim. Thanks for watching.